But what happens next?
I approached Tyler. I approached him, but he was next. He was near my mom. So that was the first thing I was worried about. Like, hold on, what you doing next to my mom? So when I approached him, he's like, oh, you got that, you got that, you got that. And then I'm just looking him in his eyes, like I'm just looking at him. I'm not saying nothing to him, not doing nothing. I got my firearm on me, but I'm not doing anything. I'm just looking at him. And then I remember when he takes off running, he showed me the direction where my brother was. My brother was down the street fighting two of the other guys. So, and it was dark. It was kind of dark down the street. You know what I'm saying? Where they, closer to where they parked at. So I remember I had started running in that direction and made sure my brother's good. And then literally as I'm getting close to my brother, that car was appearing to head towards me. And that's when I seen Tyler pulling a gun and Sebastian pulling a gun out the front windshield.
Okay, because all four of them jump in the car and two of them pull out guns on you.
Right. And on top of that, their car had no lights on too. So, I mean, that just looked like me. That's just a clear sign as a drive-by.
Okay, what happens next?
That's when I let off my 39 rounds and I saved me and my brother's life. I mean, I thank God that I, you know what I'm saying? I got to get off first because I feel like that would have been me and my brother's death at that moment.
Okay, so you fired 39 shots into the car with four people inside, two of which had guns pointed at you.
Right.
Now, the bullets are hitting all over the place. They're hitting the windows, they're hitting the different parts of the car, and they're hitting the people inside. I mean, are you actually seeing the bullets hit any of the people in the car?
I ain't see the bullets hit any of the people in the car. I seen the bullets hit in the car though, most definitely. I definitely seen the bullets hit in the car. But as far as like seeing somebody get hit, nah, I ain't see that.
Okay, you let off 39 shots. And this is the first time you've ever fired a gun outside of a driving, outside of a shooting range.
Correct.
What was that experience like firing into a car full of people?
I mean, it's just, you just got full of adrenaline. I mean, you just knowing that, like, these people really just tried to take my life, me and my brother life. You know what I'm saying? I love my life. I love my liberty. You know what I'm saying? I love my freedom. But I'm definitely willing to risk my freedom to save me and my brother's life. You know what I'm saying? So far as, like, shooting it, I mean, I did it as if I did. I've been there before. You know what I'm saying? Because, like I said, it's a dangerous world. And when you got that adrenaline and just knowing that your life on the line, like, I mean, I feel like any human being would do it. Like,
yeah.
It takes nothing just to just get that pressure off. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. So in those 39 shots, Tyler ends up getting shot, I think, in the hip.
Right?
And I mean, he survives, but I guess he runs out of the car and just runs down the street. And at which point he ends up dumping his gun in the bushes, which they later find.
Right.
Did you see him run out?
Yeah, I seen him get out of the car. So basically, like, how it went, it was like when I started shooting, their car was faced towards me. And then like the brother, he did like this 3-point turn. So as he's like, backing up or whatever, that's when I see him like get out the car, and he was like, it looked like he was trying to use the car as cover, but then he starts like running south, and that's when I see him like jump the gate and everything after I got done shooting and all that.